Thorsten really didn't get the angle that he wanted on this break ball. So he's going to have to play some pick and jab here, just knock a couple of balls loose. There, see, he just had to stun the cue ball into the side of the stack. And this is the part of the game that Thorsten doesn't really get a lot of credit for, is his ability to surgically remove balls from the rack area. And that's what we're going to see here, is we're going to see him work around the problem areas and work his way through this rack. And right here, he's going to go ahead and pocket this 15 ball and disturb a few more of these balls, just like that. And see the speed that in which he did that? Now, none of the balls are touching, and the problem that he has right now, besides trying to find a shot, is that he really doesn't have a break ball. That 8's a little bit too close to the apex of the triangle for him to really do anything with it. The 5 and the 6 are in position for a load-the-stack break shot. And you see what he's doing. He's walking the table. He is not a 14-1 statue. He walks around the table. He sees the layout from every angle. And right here, he's going to go ahead and pocket this 13 in the side pocket. Come back 1-2 rails out to the center of the table. This is the area that he wants to work in. The 7, the 6, the 5, the I believe that's the 9. And he's got to get that one ball out of that corner pocket. The one problem area that he has right now is the 4 and the 10. The 10's that strike ball that's down here in the bottom rail. And he has to find a way to get in there. And the way that these balls are laying, it's a pretty good guess that he's going to be left with either a side pocket or a behind-the-stack break ball. That is unless he can get the correct position on that 2 ball to either nudge that 7 out of the triangle area, or if he's able to knock the 5 maybe a little closer and a little bit higher to the rack area. Right now, he's going to go ahead and get rid of this one ball, and that's going to take care of a lot of problems. Comes up, and there, he's got the 5 exactly where he needs it. So now he has a break ball. He's actually got 2 if you count the 6 ball. But he still has a lot of work. The way that the 7 and the 4, I believe that's the 7 and the 2 ball, are located so close to the 5 ball, he's going to have to find a way to get behind those balls to pocket them without disturbing his break ball. That's going to be pretty difficult. And there he just went ahead and ran into the 11. So he's gotten his cue ball into trouble. The big issue right now is the 4 and the 10. You see the way he's always constantly looking at everything from every angle. There he has, goes ahead and just pockets that 11, makes sure to get it in the pocket, and played position for the easiest shot that he had on the table, which was this 14 ball. Go ahead and put that into the side. And right now he's on that 2 ball. You see him looking. He's trying to solve the problem of the 4 and the 10. And he's elected to try to pocket this 6 ball and go into the 4. Let's see how he does this. He ran into the 2 instead. He's lucky he didn't scratch there. Now he's not really left with a shot. With the exception of the 5 ball, which currently is his break ball. So, this rack not panning out the way that he wants it to. If he's got to pocket this 5 ball, then he's going to have another issue with having to create or manufacture another break ball. And I'm pretty sure the five does pass the two, and I believe that's the nine ball. There, see how he pocketed that without disturbing any of the other balls. He's going to need one of these three balls is going to have to assist him in separating the four and the ten. And look at him, he's looking at the area that he can move his cue ball through for these sequence of shots. And right now he can pocket the nine. And play position, I believe, for the seven in the opposite corner pocket. He's going to go just tap right off the rail. And he could either use the two or the seven. And I believe the two ball, he's got a perfect angle to go into the 10 ball. Perfect. And look at that. And manufactures the 10 as a behind the stack break ball. The 7 was a perfect insurance ball. So now he's got to pocket the 7 ball and either draw, and he's going to draw back for this 4 ball. Needs a little bit of angle. And right here, he can follow into position. He doesn't want to get too straight on this. He wants to get below the 10 ball. He doesn't want to hit it too hard. If he hits it too hard, he's going to come up and be on top of the 10. He doesn't want to do that. So right here, just gently tap this 4 in with a little bit of follow. Just bring it down. He's straight, but he's okay. So Thorsten is leading Darren Appleton by a score of 42-40. And currently on a 41 ball run. And as Bob Jewett racks the balls, you can see when Bob moves out of the way, you'll see just how straight that Thorsten got on this break ball. And sometimes players have a tendency of trying to force this break ball in when it's too straight, trying to create an angle, which you're going to see Thorsten probably do here. Is just try to contact that corner ball. I believe that's the 15. That's what he's looking. He's looking to contact the 1. I don't know if he's got an angle to do that and make this ball. So he's probably going to have to go into this corner. And that's pretty unfortunate. But he does have a shot. I believe that's the 2 ball that's out. He's also got a shot on that strike ball if he wants to play safe and leave Darren behind the stack. And by the way he's walking around the table, he's not thinking about playing safe. You see how he walked completely around the table, seeing this layout. Even though he only has a couple of balls out, he's looking at it from 360 degrees. Look, he's going to go around again. He wants to see what it looks like from behind the object ball. And here he's going back behind the cue ball. Very smart move. You're not going to find too many players that are smarter than this guy. He comes all the way over, draws the cue ball into the rail, setting up for a beautiful secondary break ball. And here he's going to hit this with a little bit of follow. He's got a natural tangent line angle to go right into the stack here. Perfect. Probably wanted a little bit more disturbance of the balls, but he's got that 3 ball. If you kind of evaluate this one, you've got a couple of secondary break balls with that 15 and with the 1 ball. So he'll go ahead and pocket this 3 ball. And I believe he was coming back up for the 1. Pretty sure he wanted a little bit more angle to go back up into the balls. So he's going to probably have to work either above the stack or use that 9 ball. Personally, I like using the nine ball. And the reason I like doing that is because when you pocket the nine into either one of those corner pockets and have your cue ball go up into the balls, you take away basically any chance of scratching. And you can really protect your cue ball. He's got that 11 that's sitting there as an insurance ball. Here, just goes ahead and pockets the one. And he's got a perfect angle to go right back up into the balls. Once he pockets the 9, his next shot will be the 11. That's a safety valve. Perfect. Kind of shooting over this 13 ball. I don't think it's anything he can't handle. You see him looking at the 15 to see if the 15 is out enough as a break ball. He's going to end up shooting over the 13 to pocket this 11. And the key here is to get another shot. And I believe from here he is either on the 15 or he's on the 5. If he shoots off the 15, which I believe is on the line, I don't believe the 15 is completely out of the stack. And he's looking at the 7, seeing if the 7's in position. He's always walking around and he's always evaluating the layout. There's a lot to be learned from that. Here, I believe he can elect to shoot either the 7 or the 5, but he's got to deal with these balls that are stuck in the rack area. He's got to find a way to disturb these balls and at least get them to where they're not touching each other. And I'm pretty sure he likes this 5 ball as a break ball more than he likes this 7. Now the 5 is in a little better position. Here he goes ahead and pockets the 7, comes back over, sets up absolutely perfect on the 13 ball. And as I said at the beginning, this is the area of the game that I believe Thorsten doesn't get a lot of credit for, is his ability to work like a surgeon through the rack area within close proximity. A lot of people think that Thorsten just blasts the balls apart and just has 14 open shots. He is a very skilled, very high level, very intelligent 14-1 player. And here you see the way he's set up to go from the 8 to the 6. One rail, he's going to have his cue ball drift down towards the 6. Doesn't want to get straight, wants to leave an angle to come up on this 5 ball. Here he just wants his cue ball to gently drift up to the 5. He wants to be right on top. So he's now on a 55 ball run. You'll see the angle that he has to get into the stack when Bob moves out of the way. And I'm pretty sure he can follow this break ball. The issue here is distance. There's a lot of distance between the break ball and the stack. So increased distance, you want to minimize what you're doing with the cue ball. He's going to draw this. He's lucky he didn't get stuck there. But once again, he's left with a bunch of balls stuck in that rack area. and he's got to get right back into that surgical precision mode of working his way through the rack. He's going to start pocketing the 11 ball. He's got a pretty good shot here on this ball. I believe that's a 2 ball. Let's follow forward. He wants to get on this 1 ball. This 1 ball is the key to opening up the rest of the balls. And I want you to pay special attention to the speed of the cue ball, the speed of his shaft, transferred to the cue ball, and into the rest of these balls. Absolutely perfect. Still has a little problem with the 13 and the 15, the 7 and the 8, 13 and the 14. I don't believe any of these balls are touching each other. But he does have to pay special attention, especially to the 7 and the 8, because they're so close to the stack area. See him walking around the table. He's going to see exactly how much room his cue ball has to get in on that 7. And the mark of a good player is when you see them walking the table, walking back and forth, looking behind the object ball, looking from behind the pocket, back to behind the cue ball. You see where he's standing now, looking at this shot from every single angle, looking at the layout from every single angle. And he's elected to pocket the 3 ball. And from here, he's got his cue ball has the clearance to pocket the 7. Constantly walking, constantly examining the table. He evaluates the table from just about every single angle that there is. He elected to stop his cue ball to pocket the strike ball, which is down on the rail. Get rid of that. What he's looking at is he really doesn't have a break ball. The only ball that could serve as a break ball right now, possibly the 13, it's going to be very hard to hold that ball there due to the position of the 4 and the 14. So I'm pretty sure he's going to be working towards getting a shot on this 8 ball. That is unless he can pocket the 6 in the side and split up the 14 and the 13. I believe that's a 14 and the 9 ball. And he elected to play position on this 4. Or is he on the 14? I believe he's on the 14 ball in the side pocket. So he's got 2 balls to choose from, either the 8 or the 9. And I think he's elected to go below the stack again using the 8 ball. He's got perfect shot here to draw back, get on these 2 strike balls, the 13 and the 15. Here, just draw back for the 15. What he's going to look at here is he's looking at the proper angle to get his cue ball to pocket the 4 and just follow forward for the 8 ball. He goes over and he double checks every single shot. Very smart move. They're absolutely perfect. This is a much better angle than what he had on the behind the stack break ball that he had a few racks ago. The biggest difference being freedom to move his cue ball. He's not as straight as he was. He's got a little bit of an angle. He just has to be careful not to let go of the cue ball. And we'll be able to see the angle that he has once Bob moves out of the way. He's going to have the freedom to follow. What I don't like is that he's going into that center ball. I believe that's the 13. Hard to tell with the 8 blocking our view. But you see how he's using a high ball. There, kind of lucky he didn't get spit back into the corner pocket. There's some crowd noise. But right now, he does have a shot. He has a shot on the one ball. And what you see him doing is he's walking around the table looking at the four ball, which is on the rail. And now he just looked at the 13 to see if he could use that as a secondary break ball. So once again, he was unable to get a good spread off of his break ball. So he's going to have to find a way to get a secondary break shot either on this 10 ball or behind the stack on the 13, which is what he appears to be looking at. If he wants to get in there, he could probably get in there now by pocketing, just getting rid of this 10 ball and following forward. And here he's just got a natural angle to pull his cue ball probably up into that strike ball, which is in the middle of that cluster of balls, that bottom ball. He doesn't want to do it too hard. Doesn't want to hit the cue ball too hard and send the balls all over the table, because he wants to develop a break ball off of this shot right here. A lot of players believe that they have to smash the balls all over the table. I mean, it might look intimidating, it might sound intimidating, but it's really not a smart move. On a shot like this, Thorsten is looking to pocket the 13, disperse the cluster, and he's got the 7 sitting there as an insurance ball. So it's a three-part task. And he knows that if he lets go of his cue ball, or if he tries to fire it in too much at too much velocity, that bad things happen, and he's not gonna have too many candidates up around that rack area. And I think what he's doing right now is he's looking at the four ball, seeing if the Oh, he pocketed the 7. So now he's drawn his attention down here to the 9 and the 4. Pulls the cue ball up into the rail. You see how he always keeps going, looking back to see how he's going to attack the cluster of balls. Here he's just going to draw a little bit off the rail here, out the center table. And I'm not sure if he's got the angle to use this 15 or not. I doubt that he'll use the 15 to go into the balls, and looks as though he's going to use this 5 to possibly set up to get on the proper side of the 13 ball. And this is one of those either or situations. He could shoot the 5 or the 15. Depends on which side that he wants to attack that 13 from. And I believe this is the right choice, using this 5 ball, just pulling the cue down to the rail. Perfect angle to just follow and disperse the balls. Just going to follow this. Nice speed. Perfect. Has a break ball now with that 2 ball. And wants to get rid of these 2 balls that are on the rail. And these balls connect very easily. Right here, he wants to bypass his break ball. He doesn't want to crash into it. He can elect to go to the three ball next, or even come down to pocket the 15. That's his choice. And that's a smart move. He's placed his cue ball in a position where he can shoot either ball. He's elected to get that three ball. It's pretty close to the rail. And right now, it's just get on the break ball. So we've seen quite a few racks where he has had to work and dissect the rack instead of just blasting it to pieces. So right now he just wants to get his cue ball around the center of the table. And there it is. Absolutely perfect.